हेलो एवरीवन, इस पूरी सीरीज के अंदर हम पूरे सिलेबस को कवर करेंगे ऑन डिजिटल लॉजिक। और डिजिटल लॉजिक के अंदर जितने भी सिलेबस है, पूरा जो स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक हम पूरा टॉपिक जो है सब कवर करेंगे, और उसके साथ साथ हम कुछ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस को भी यहाँ पर कवर करेंगे। तो आई होप जो क्लासेस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा। तो आई थिंक यू नो माई नेम, माई नेम इज़ हिमांशु कौशिक, और मुझे गेट की फील्ड में स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाते हुए बहुत टाइम हो चुका है। मैं इंडिया के बेस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशंस के साथ ऑलरेडी काम कर चुका हूँ, और सब पहली बार मैंने गेट एग्ज़ाम क्लियर किया था, दैट वॉज इन 2011-12। तो ऑब्वियसली आप देख सकते हो कि इसी फील्ड में मुझे लगभग 10 साल से ज़्यादा एक्सपीरियंस हो चुका है। तो ऑब्वियसली हमारा जो एक्सपीरियंस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा, तो इसी वजह से आप जो हमारी क्लासेस है उसको ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं। और अगर आप मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं ऑन अन अकेडमी, तो अन अकेडमी पे मेरे पास दो तरह के कोर्सेज जो होते हैं। पहला जो है दैट इज़ कॉल्ड प्लस कोर्स, एंड सेकेंड इज़ आइकॉनिक कोर्स। तो प्लस कोर्स में स्पेशल ये है कि यहाँ पर इंडिया के बेस्ट टीचर्स यहाँ पर होते हैं, और साथ साथ में जो मेरी क्लासेस होती है काफ़ी इंट्रैक्टिव होती है, यानी कि आप और मैं क्लासेस के बीच में इंट्रैक्टिव या डिस्कशन हम लोग कर सकते हैं। और साथ साथ में जब आप आइकॉनिक कोर्स में जाएंगे तो आइकॉनिक में स्पेशल है, स्पेशल ये है कि एक मेंटर आपके साथ हमेशा साथ रहेगा। तो मेंटर, जब भी आपको कोई भी डाउट रहेगा, आपको कोई भी नोट्स की ज़रूरत होगी या फिर आपको कोई मोटिवेशन की ज़रूरत होगी, तो मेंटर हमेशा आपको सपोर्ट करेगा इन एनी वे। तो अगर मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं विद अन अकेडमी, चाहे आप प्लस ले या फिर आइकॉनिक ले, मेरा कोई भी कोर्स अगर आप लेना चाहते हैं, जस्ट यूज़ अ कूपन कोड विच इज़ कौशिक 10, क्योंकि कौशिक 10 में आपको टोटल 10% ऑफ हमको मिल जाएगा। जस्ट यूज दिस एंड होप यू लाइक दिस। पूरी सीरीज जो है आपको बहुत अच्छी लगेगी, एंड थैंक यू सो मच। हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ कैन यू कंबाइन सेल्स सो दैट यू कैन मिनिमाइज अ बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन यूजिंग के मैप्स। सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, इन द के मैप्स वी यूज द ग्रे कोड, एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज ग्रे कोड्स यू कैन कंबाइन टू एडजेसेंट सेल्स so that one of the variables can be minimized. Okay, so let me first show you with the help of example, then you will be able to understand. So here you can see this is representing a four variable k map. So in a four variable k map, any two adjacent cells, even if you take row wise or even if you take column wise, any two adjacent cells, they are having a change of only one bit, correct? So if they are having a change of only one bit, that means you can combine these cells so that you can minimize one variable. Okay, so you can make cells of size 2, you can make cells of size 4, you can make cells of size 8, and so on. I mean, the cells you are going to make will be in the powers of 2. Okay, let me explain with the help of examples, then you will understand. I'll come back to this diagram later on, and then again I'll tell you swarm kaise kar sakte hain, how can we do it. So look at this example here. Look at this example. We have the following expression. This is representing a Boolean expression, and this expression is representing a complement b complement c plus a complement bc. ठीक है, क्या represent कर रहा है? A complement b complement c plus a complement bc. Now in this expression, if you follow the rules of Boolean algebra, then you can take a complement and c as common, and then inside we are going to have b complement plus b. That means only one variable is changed. This is the combination, and the result will be a complement c. And the same one here can also be represented by this k map. So this k map, this location is representing your a complement b complement c, and this location is representing a complement b c. And these are two adjacent cells, they are having only one bit of change, therefore I can combine them and I can remove the variable which is changing. So here you can see this 0 is changing to 1. So because 0 is changing to 1, so I can remove this variable here, and I can write this 0 and this 1. One is, this 0 is representing a complement and this 1 is representing c. Therefore the solution is a complement c. Now in the second case, we have the following expression. This is your Boolean expression. So in this Boolean expression, the variable a is changing. So I can represent this by this cell. So ye jo cell hai, this cell is representing your a complement bc, and this cell here, it is representing your abc. So from the rules of Boolean algebra, you can take a complement as you can take bc as common. If you take bc as common, then inside you will get a complement plus a. So because you will get a complement plus a, that is why I can remove the variable a complement plus a. You can clearly see here a is changing its value. the value of a is changing from 0 to 1, so I can remove this variable. Here you can see, here we have bc and bc are having the same values, unki value jo hai wo constant hai, wo same hai. Even if we have these two cells which are on two different ends, agar in sabhi cells ke beech mein you have change of only one variable, if you have change of only one variable, then you can combine these cells. Jaise ye jo cell hai, this cell is representing the value a b complement c complement, and this cell is representing the value a b c complementation. So mathematically I can take a c complement as common. So here you can clearly see a is not changing its value, the value of a is same in both the cells, as well as the value of c is also same. C is having 0, c is having 0, only b is changing its value. So because b is changing its value, so I can remove the variable b and I can get a c complement. So yahan se you can get a and you can get c complement, the solution will be a c complement. Okay, I'll take a lot of examples. Initially I have to explain you how to do it, but when you will do it in the practice, it will hardly take you 5 seconds to solve the problem. So bahut easily aap solve kar payenge. First I'm trying to explain what the concept is, what is the reason behind we are going to combine the cells, and then when we will solve the problem, you will see how easy it is to solve the problems using the help of K-map. Now here, this is a 4 variable K-map, and the expression that we have is a complement b complement c complement d, and this is a b complement c complement d. So this is representing a complement b complement c complement d, this is representing a b complement c complement d. So that means in these two cells only one variable is changing. Which variable is changing? Only this variable a is changing its value, the variable a is changing the value from 0 to 1, and all the other variables are having exactly the same value. So I can just write all the other variables here. So after writing all the other variables here, removing a, I will get b complement c complement d. So this is our solution here. तो ये आपका सॉल्यूशन होगा, ओके? Now look at this one. Now this K map is representing 3 minterms. यहाँ पर 3 minterms हैं आपके पास. The first minterm is A complement B complement C. The second minterm is A complement B C complement, and the third minterm is A B C. Represent them with the help of a K map. So in this K map, we are having a 3 variable K map. So in the 3 variable K map, you are going to have total of 8 cells. Out of these 8 cells, 3 cells are having a value 1, other cells are having a value 0. So these 3 cells which are representing a value 1, they are representing minterms. Ye minterms ko represent kar rahe hain. And these cells which are having a value 0, they are representing the max terms. Wo max term ko represent kar rahe hain. So what I can simply do is, I can take a combination here, which is BC. I can take a combination here, which is, you know, so in this combination, BC is same, only A is changing the value. And in this combination, A complement is same, only B is changing its value. So simply I can do, from this combination, I can say it is A complement is same, as well as C is same. And from this combination, I can say it is BC is same. Therefore, the solution will be A complement C plus BC. So the solution hoga, wo aapka A complement C plus BC hoga. You can also do the same with the help of Boolean expression. Aap isko Boolean expression se bhi kar sakte hain. Okay, so I think here you can see we have 4 variables. Aapke paas 4 variables hai yahan par. We have the variables which is A complement B complement C, we have A complement BC, we have ABC, and we have ABC complement. So I'm representing all of these variables here. Now there's something very interesting. Okay, so here this subset is possible. You can say this subcube is possible. We will not call it as a rectangle, we will call it as a subcube, right? Why I'm calling it as a subcube? Because these are coming in the powers of 2. For example, 2 raised to power 0. So cell can be of having only one, matlab jo aapka subcube hai, that can be of having only one element, right? So here you can see each of these cell is representing a subcube. So that is 2 raised to power 0, a subcube of size 1. We can have subcube of size 2. 2 raised to power 1. So here you can see this is representing a subcube of size 2. This is representing a subcube of size 2. This is representing a subcube of size 2. We can also have subcube of size 2 raised to power 2. That means 4 cells. We cannot combine 3 cells in a K-map. We can combine 4 cells. We can have a subcube of size 2 raised to power 3. That is 8 cells. We can have a subcube of size 2 raised to power 4, that is 16 cells. So basically, whenever you are going to combine these variables, these subcubes are having a size which is in the powers of 2. The size of each of these subcubes will be in the power of 2. ठीक है. नाउ इन दिस केस, नाउ इन दिस केस इफ यू कैन इट वेरी क्लियरली यहां पर क्या हो रहा है. सो दीज बोथ ऑफ दीज वंस आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस सब क्यूब एज वेल एज both of these ones are included in the subcube, but these two ones are included in two different subcubes. ये जो दो ones हैं, I mean this one and this one, they are included in two different subcubes. ये दो अलग-अलग subcubes में included है. So we do not have to take it. हमें को नहीं लेना है. Why we do not have to take it? Because this is not an essential prime implicate. ये एक essential prime implicate नहीं है. ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट. हम लोग इसके बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे स्टेप बाय स्टेप. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट. जस्ट नाउ जस्ट नो दैट वी हैव थ्री टर्मिनोलॉजीज. वन इज वी हैव इम्प्लिकेंट. सेकेंड इज योर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, करेक्ट. एंड द थर्ड वन इज योर असेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. थर्ड इज असेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. तो हमारे पास तीन टर्मिनोलॉजीज हैं यहाँ पर. एक है इम्प्लिकेंट, दूसरा है प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट और तीसरा है असेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. लेट मी गिव यू ब्रीफ आइडिया. अभी मैं आई एम नॉट डिस्कसिंग इन डेप्थ रिगार्डिंग इम्प्लिकेंट, प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट और असेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दीज थ्री टर्मिनोलॉजीज इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. राइट नाउ लेट मी जस्ट गिव यू ब्रीफ आइडिया. सो एवरी सब क्यूब इज एन इम्प्लिकेंट. इवन इफ वी हैव अ सब क्यूब ऑफ साइज 2^0. जैसे इफ आई जस्ट टॉक अबाउट दिस सिंगल वन, this is an implicant. This single one is an implicant. This single one is an implicant. This single one is an implicant. So every subcube, right, is an implicant. Even you can see, this is a subcube of size 2. It is also representing an implicant. It is a subcube of size 2. It is also representing an implicant. It is a subcube of size 2. It is also representing an implicant. Implicant means every subcube is an implicant. And the size of subcube will be 2^0, 2^1, 2^2, 2^3, 2^4. Any of these subcubes will be representing an implicant. Clear? Then we have prime implicant. Prime implicant means any implicant which is not completely a part of another subcube, which is not completely a part of another implicant. Jaise, let me explain with the help of example. Dekho, this one is representing an implicant. This one is representing an implicant. But the problem here is, both of these ones are also a part of third implicant. ये जो दोनों one है वो एक तीसरे implicant के अंदर भी आता है. Both of them are coming within this third implicant. So basically, this third implicant, which is not a inside another implicant, then that is called as S prime implicant. This is called as prime implicant. जैसे let me show you here. So this one and this one symbol, these both are implicant, but this bigger subcube is a prime implicant. Now this one is an implicant, this one is an implicant, correct, but this bigger one is a prime implicant. Then you can say, sir, ye jo bigger subcube hai, for this bigger subcube some part of this subcube is coming in this implicant and some part of this bigger subcube is coming in this subcube, right? To iska kuch part hai jo is wale subcube ke andar aata hai, kuch part hai is wale subcube ke andar aata hai. So that means see, this subcube is not entirely a part of another one. Matlab entirely ka matlab kya hai? You have a box and you are putting something inside the box, right? This something is completely inside the box. Agar ye completely is box ke andar hai, iska matlab hai this box is a prime implicant and this inside one is a, right, only implicant, correct? But if some part of this box is coming in this box, some part of this box is coming in this box, right, then we will not call this one as a implicant. This will become a prime implicant, correct? So basically, every prime implicant is also an implicant. Har ek prime implicant jo hai, wo ek implicant ko represent karta hai, okay? Then third one is essential prime implicant. So essential prime implicant ka matlab kya hai? Is there any prime implicant which is covering a one which is not covered by anyone else? Jaise, if you look at this implicant, ye jo implicant hai, this implicant is a prime implicant, right? But at the same time, this implicant is also essential prime. ये जो implicant है यहाँ पर, ये एक essential prime implicant भी है. Why? Because it is covering this one and this one is not covered by any other subcube. इस one को किसी भी subcube ने cover नहीं किया. And here in this subcube is also essential prime implicant because it is covering one term. ये एक ऐसी term को cover कर रहा है that is not covered by any other prime implicant. But if you look at this subcube here, this subcube, So this subcube is just an implicant, but it is not essential prime. This subcube is just a prime implicant, but it is not essential prime. ये सिर्फ एक prime implicant है, ये essential prime implicant नहीं है. It is not representing an essential prime implicant. Why it is not representing an essential prime implicant? Because it is not covering anyone that is covered by others. मतलब ये कुछ ऐसी term को cover नहीं कर रहा जिसको कोई और cover ना कर रहा हूँ. ये दो terms को cover कर रहा है and both of these two terms are covered by other essential prime implicants. ठीक है. So in any of your solutions, we should have all the essential prime implicants. Let's say this is representing an essential prime implicant. This is also representing an essential prime implicant. So in any of your solution, all of your essential prime implicants should come, right? But for prime implicants, we have to choose whether this prime implicant should come or should not come. So if I'm giving a solution for this equation, now this one should be present in the solution. ये जो है, ये किसको present कर रहा है? A complement C. And this one is also essential prime implicant. ये किसको represent कर रहा है? AB. So in any of your solution, all the essential prime implicants should be there. But for some prime implicants, we have to choose whether it should be there in the solution or it should not be there in the solution. Okay? We will discuss about it. हम इसके बारे में ज़्यादा detail में discuss करेंगे. We are going to have a complete discussion about it. Even if you could not understand anything. Even if you just know कि हमारे पास ये तीन terminologies है, as of now, that is fine. You should only know that there exists a terminology which is implicant, there exists a terminology which is prime implicant, and there exists a terminology essential prime. अभी आपको सिर्फ ये तीन terminologies को करना है, because we are going to have a complete video, we are going to have a complete discussion on this topic. Okay? Right now, just understand, for this K-map, we can get multiple solutions, but here, if I say I want to have a unique or I want to have a minimized Boolean expression, so in that minimized Boolean expression, all the essential prime implicants should be there, and for prime implicants, we have to make a choice. Okay? If you solve the same expression using Boolean rules, how can you do it? How can you do it? From these two, I can take A complement C as common. From these two, I can take AB as common, and then B plus B complement is 1, C plus C complement is 1. Therefore, the solution is A complement C plus AB. Okay? Okay, let me take another example. So, in this example, we are creating a subcube of size 4. यहाँ पर जो subcube है, उसका size 4 है. And all of these 4 cells should be adjacent. ठीक है, जैसे in this case is representing an expression. ये किस expression को represent कर रहा? This is representing a function f of abc. And in this abc, we are having summation 4, 5, 6 and 7. It is having summation 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. That means it is having 4 minterms. Now when you are putting all these 4 minterms here, now in this case, there are a lot of implicants are possible. There are a lot of essential prime. Okay, let me show you implicant kya yahan par, essential prime implicant kya hai. How many implicants are there and how many essential prime implicants are there. First of all, let us just look at what are the number of implicants. Yahan par kitne implicants hai. What are the number of implicants? So this single one is an implicant, second implicant, third implicant, fourth implicant. Then we have 5 implicant, 6 implicant and 7 implicant. And then this bigger one is your 8 implicants. So in this one, we have a total of 8 implicants. Aapke paas yahan par 8 implicants hai. We have a total of 8 implicants. Clear? Then how many implicants are there which are prime implicants? यहाँ पर अगर आपके पास 8 implicants हैं, तो इन 8 में से कितने prime implicants हैं? How many of them are prime implicant? Okay? So this bigger subcube here, this bigger subcube is only one prime implicant. यहाँ पर prime implicant सिर्फ एक ही है. It is only having only one prime implicant. We do not have more than one prime implicant. Because even if you take this subcube, so this subcube is a part of this bigger subcube. Correct? So this cannot be a prime implicant. Even if you take this subcube is also a part of this bigger subcube. So the biggest subcube that you can have, the biggest subcube that you can make, that biggest subcube is going to represent a prime implicant. Okay? And how can you make subcube? Aap subcube kaise bana sakte hain? You can only combine those cells where there's a change of only one bit. Right? So here between these two cells, only one bit is changed. Between these two cells, only one bit is changed. Between these two cells, only one bit is changed. That is why I can combine this subcube of size 4. And when you look at this subcube, then what are the variables that are changing? So C is changing as well as B is also changing. So B and C both are changing. Only variable that is remaining the same is A. Therefore, because only A is remaining, so I can say that this entire K map is representing only the variable A. In the same way, if you look at this K map, now in this K map, we have, all of these locations are representing a 1. Okay? So, if you look at it very clearly, then you will find that this is representing a function f of a, comma, b, comma, c, comma, d, which is equal to summation 3, 7, 15, right, and 11. Okay? So, it is representing summation 3, 5, 3, 7, 15, and 11. Okay? Now, again, here you can combine subcubes. So this is the biggest subcube you can have, and this biggest subcube is representing a prime implicant as well as it is also representing essential prime implicant. Now in this biggest subcube, only CD is not changing. CD is remaining the same. A and B both are changing their values. Therefore, if you look at the solution, solution is CD, right? Solution jo hai, wo yahan par hoga CD. Okay. Now look at this one here. So here three examples are there. How are the other subcubes you can make? Now in this example, you can combine these four cells. Why I can combine these four cells, sir? Why? Because here, first of all, it is having a size of 4. And if you look at these two cells, only one bit is changed. But if you look at these two cells, only one bit is changed. So basically, we can have a subcube of size in the powers of 2. So this is 2 raised to power 2. So the subcube of size 4. Okay. Here again, if you look at this cell and this cell, only one bit is changed. Why? Look at this cell. This cell is representing A, B, C complement, D complement. And this cell is representing A, B, C, D complement. So here you can see only C is changing. Only C is changing and A, B, D complement is same. So that is why I can combine this subcube and this subcube. In the same way, I can combine this subcube and this subcube. In the same way, I can combine these two subcubes and these two subcubes. So I can take a subcube of size 4. So here I can take a subcube of size 4. Now in this subcube of size 4, what variable is not changing? You will see A is not changing. As well as you can see that D is not changing. C is changing as well as B is changing. Therefore, in your solution, you will get A, D complement. The solution of this K map is A, D complement. Okay? So you can clearly see it is A, D complement. And if you look at this K map, again, you will find that this subcube and this subcube, only one bit is changing. So I can combine all of these four corner subcubes. Jitne bhi aapke corner ke subcube hai, aap sabhi ko combine kar sakte hain. And if you combine all of these four subcubes, then you will see that D is not changing here as well as B is not changing here. That means the solution will be D complement and B complement. So we have BD complement. Okay. So this is basically B complement dot D complement. Ye B complement dot D complement hai. So there's some printing mistake. You can rectify the mistake. Here also it is A D complement. Here is B complement dot D complement. Okay. Now again here what you can see, we have one in this location, we have one in this location, one in this location, one in this location, one in this, one in this, and one in this. Now in this case, we cannot have a subcube of size 7. Hamare paas size 7 ka subcube nahi ho sakta. The subcubes can be of size 2, the subcubes can be of size 4, the subcube can be of size 8. We cannot have a subcube of size 7. So now what I can do here is, I can make this subcube, it is of size 4. I can make this subcube, it is of size 4. I can make this subcube, it is of size 4. So basically, in every question, in every K map, we always have to try and make the biggest subcube which is possible. Hame sabse bada subcube banana hai. We try to make one of the biggest subcube. Correct? So yahan par what you can even do is, you can do it something like this. You can only combine these two ones, but that will not create a biggest subcube. when you create a biggest subqueue, in that case the number of variables that it can represent can also be, you know, jo number of variables ye represent kar sakta hai usko hum minimize kar sakte hain, or you can say minimize the number of literals. Now if you look at this entire subqueue here, is pure subqueue mein AC AB is remaining and everything else is changing, so AB is will be in the solution. In this subqueue only AC is not changing, others are changing. In this subqueue only AD is not changing, others are changing. Okay, theek hai, clear hai. Now there is something very interesting property yahan pe, bahut hi interesting property hai. There is something very very interesting. Dekho, this is representing the number of variables in a function, number of variables in a function. Okay, fine. And this is representing the size of subqueue. This is representing the size of subqueue. इसको थोड़ा सा ध्यान से समझिएगा, प्लीज फोकस ऑन इट, वेरी फोकस ऑन इट क्लियरली. सो दिस के मैप इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ टोटल साइज ऑफ, आई मीन दिस के मैप इज हैविंग टोटल फोर वेरिएबल्स. हाउ मेनी वेरिएबल्स आर देयर? वी आर हैविंग फोर वेरिएबल्स, व्हिच इज ए बी सी एंड डी. वी आर हैविंग फोर वेरिएबल्स, टोटल फोर वेरिएबल्स आर देयर. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ दिस सबक्यूब? इस सबक्यूब का साइज कितना है? सो दिस सबक्यूब इज हैविंग अ साइज ऑफ 4. So if this subcube is having a size 4, now this 4 can be represented by 2 raised to power 2. 2 raised to power 2. Now this 2 is important. Ye jo power wala 2 hai, this 2 which is coming in the power, this 2 is important. Why this 2 is important? Because in this subcube which is of size 4, the number of variables will be 4 minus 2. Ye 4 kaun sa hai? The number of variables. Ye 2 kaun sa hai? This 2. Okay, clear? Okay, let me explain you one more time. देखो, if I make a smaller subcubes, अगर मैं if I try to make only this subcube, अगर मैं आपको सिर्फ ये वाला subcube बनाने की कोशिश करता हूँ, थोड़ा focus कीजिएगा, please focus here. If I try to make only this subcube, right? So this subcube is of size 2, that means 2 raised to power 1. Now the min term that this subcube will be representing, ये subcube जिस min term को represent करेगा, that min term will be having 4 minus 1 variables. इसकी जो भी min term बनेगी उसके अंदर 4 minus 1 variables होंगे. 4 कहाँ से आया? Total number of variables are 4. ये 1 कहाँ से आया? That is 2 raised to power 1. So जितना भी subcube का size है, जो उसकी power है, उसको अगर आप 4 से subtract करेंगे, then you will find out that how many variables can be minimized. अगर आप इस सबक्यूब को चेक करेंगे, then you will find out that A is not changing, B is changing, as well as C complement and D is remaining the same. तो C complement और D है, वो यहाँ पर सेम है. So this subcube will be of size, क्या साइज होगा इसका? This subcube is of size 2, therefore 3 variables will be there. यहाँ पर 3 variables होंगे. Okay, let me take more examples, then you will understand. Okay, so we have this expression. Let us try to first minimize this expression, then maybe you can understand from this. Okay, so here this is a function of 3 variables. Function kitne variables ka aapke paas? 3 variables ka hai. So I'm going to make a k-map with 3 variables. Okay, so a 3 variable k-map will be having total of 4 cells. So I'm taking a variable A here, I'm taking a variable B and C here. ठीक है, स्टेप बाय स्टेप आई एम डूइंग एवरीथिंग, ताकि आप सभी को समझ में आए. इफ यू आई थिंक यू शुड बी एबल टू फॉलो मी, आप सभी मेरे को फॉलो कर पाएंगे इसके बाद. आई वांट ऑल ऑफ यू कि आप मुझे इसके बाद फॉलो कर पाए. ओके, नाउ दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ 3 वेरिएबल के मैप. सो दिस लोकेशन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग 0, दिस रिप्रेजेंटिंग 1, दिस इज 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ द फर्स्ट वैल्यू हियर इज A B complement C, that means 101 101, मतलब 5. ठीक है, so I can also give them a number. मतलब basically क्या होता है कि if you give them number, it becomes very fast to solve these equations. तो I do not really need to write this, मुझे ये लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है. I do not have to write it. Why I do not have to write it? I can just slightly give it number. I can say it is cell number 0, cell number 1, cell number 2, cell number 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now this is representing value 5. This is 001, which is 1. This is 011, which is 3. This is 100, which is 4. दिस इज 0 0 0 विच इज 0. अब आप क्लियरली कह सकते हैं ना, आई कैन क्लियरली से दैट एट लोकेशन 0 वी आर हैविंग अ 1, एट लोकेशन 4 वी आर हैविंग अ 1, एट लोकेशन 3 वी आर हैविंग अ 1, एट लोकेशन 1 वी आर हैविंग अ 1, एट लोकेशन 5 वी आर हैविंग अ 1. सो दीज आर द लोकेशंस जहां पर आपके पास 1 है. क्लियर है सबके साथ? इज इट क्लियर? अब थोड़ा सा ध्यान दीजिएगा बिकॉज दिस पार्ट इज लिटिल ट्रिकी. अब थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी पार्ट आएगा, सो आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू फोकस हियर. सो आई वॉन्ट टू मेक द बिगेस्ट सब क्यूब दैट इज पॉसिबल. जो सबसे बड़ा सब क्यूब पॉसिबल है मैं वो बनाना चाहता हूँ. तो आई कैन मेक दिस सब क्यूब, करेक्ट? दिस इज द बिगेस्ट सब क्यूब. सो दिस वन विल नॉट बी इंक्लूडेड इन दिस. वाई? बिकॉज द साइज ऑफ सब क्यूब विल ओनली बी इन द पावर्स ऑफ 2. सेकेंडली, आई कैन मेक दिस सब क्यूब. So this subcube is also essential prime implicant, as well as this subcube is also essential prime implicant. ठीक है? अब कुछ चीजें analyze करते हैं before I give you the solution. Let me analyze a few things here. So the size of this entire subcube is 4. ठीक है? क्या size है इसका? 4. And 4 can be written as 2 raised to power 2. ठीक है? यानी कि इस सबक्यूब से जो भी मेरे पास एक्सप्रेशन आएगी, दैट एक्सप्रेशन विल बी हैविंग 3 - 2 = 1 वेरिएबल्स. उस एक्सप्रेशन में सिर्फ एक ही वेरिएबल होगा. व्हाट इज 3? 3 इज द नंबर ऑफ वेरिएबल्स इन दिस एक्सप्रेशन. व्हाट इज 2? 2 इज द पावर. ठीक है? सो लेट अस लुक एट दिस वन. 0 1, दिस इज 0 0, एंड दिस इज 0 1. So we can clearly see A is changing as well as C is changing. The only thing that is not changing is B. So from this subcube, I can find out B complement. ये जो subcube है, वो सिर्फ B complement को represent कर रहा है. That means only one variable is there. Okay. Now let us look at the second one. If you look at this subcube here, the size of this subcube is 2, and 2 can be written as 2 raised to power 1. 2 क्या लिख सकते हैं हम लोग? 2 raised to power 1. So now we have 3 variables, and if I do 3 - 1, that is equal to 2. यानी कि इस subcube से मेरे पास जो term आएगी, the expression that I will get, in that expression only 2 variables will be there. जैसे what I can do here is, if you look at it here, A is not changing, right? So it is 0 0 0 1 and 1 1. So A is not changing, only C is changing. C change कर रहा है, B is also not changing. Therefore this one is representing A complement and B complement. ये जो सबक्यूब है, C is not changing, only B is changing. C जो है वो चेंज नहीं कर रहा, सिर्फ B चेंज कर रहा है. ओके? सो B इज चेंजिंग फ्रॉम 0 to 1, बट C इज रिमेनिंग द सेम. C जो है वो 1 है. देयरफॉर हियर आई विल गेट A कॉम्प्लीमेंट C. यहां से मुझे क्या मिलेगा? A कॉम्प्लीमेंट C. देयरफॉर व्हाट इज द सॉल्यूशन हियर? व्हाट इज द सॉल्यूशन इक्वेशन? द सॉल्यूशन विल बी B कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस A कॉम्प्लीमेंट C. सॉल्यूशन होगा आपके पास B कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस A कॉम्प्लीमेंट C. दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन इक्वेशन फॉर दिस गिवन एक्सप्रेशन. ठीक है? ये इस एक्सप्रेशन के लिए सॉल्यूशन इक्वेशन होगी. ओके? आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. आप सभी को ये सॉल्यूशन समझ में आया होगा. लेट अस डू वन थिंग. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेट मी टेक फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सम बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस, एंड लेट मी ट्राई टू सॉल्व दोज बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस. ओके? विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. नाउ हेलो एवरीवन, in this video we are going to look at some of the examples of k-map, and remember all the k-maps, all the expressions that I'm solving so far, all of them are sum of product expressions, or you can say SOP expression. I have not taken any product of some expressions that I will take in the next video. So right now we are just solving some expressions, some boolean expressions using the k-map, and I just wanted to give a brief idea behind this. Then again, we will learn a lot more concepts, a lot of new concepts in the next video. Okay? So let us, before moving ahead, let us look at these examples. So this example here, we are having 4 variables. The variables are A, B, C, D, and we want to minimize this expression. Kaise minimize karenge? Let us look at this one. So for 4 variables, we are going to have a K-map, which is going to have 16 entries. There are 16 combinations of 4 variables. Okay? Now here, because we have the variables A, B, C, D, I'm going to take A, B here, and I'm going to take C, D here. Clear? Now, let us number them. This is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. And I can number each of these cells. I can say this is cell number 0, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. In this way, I can number each of these cells. Now let us look at these expressions. So this is representing 0, 1, 0, 0. Yani ki this number is 4. This is representing 0, 1, 0, 1, which is 10. Sorry, this is not 10, this is 5. This is 5. This is representing 1, 1, 0, 0, which is 12. This is 1, 1, 0, 1, which is 13. This is 1, 0, 0, 1, which is 9. 0, 0, 1, 0, that is 2. So that means these locations are having 1. Congruency location hai. We have 4, here we have a 1. We have 5, here we have a 1. We have 12, 1, 13, 1, 9. Here we have a 1 and we have 1 at the location 2. So yahan par ab aapke paas 1 hai. These are the locations where we have 1. So what are the subcubes possible? Yahan par kya kya subcube possible hai? I can make this subcube. So you see, I want to make a subcube which is as big as possible. I want to have big subcubes, because if I can make big subcubes, then I can minimize the number of variables. Okay. And now the second subcube that I can do here is, this is your second subcube. And now this one cannot be combined with any subcube. Isko hum kisi bhi subcube ke sath combine nahi kar sakte, because we could have combined this with the corners. I mean, this could have combined with this, or this could have combined with this, or we could have combined this one with this one or this one, right? But again, there is no other one here. So I cannot combine this one with anyone. So this is again an implicant, which is also essential prime. So this one here, if I look at this subcube, in this subcube, variable B is same. Variable B jo hai, wo same hai, as well as variable C is same. So this is representing B, C complementation. Okay. And for this subcube, the variable A is same, as well as the variable CD is same, variable B is changing. So it is A, C complement D. And for this subcube, we have A complement, B complement, and then we have C, D complement. Therefore, if I can add all of them, then my solution equation will be BC complement plus AC complement D plus A complement, B complement, C, D complement. So you can clearly see how easy it was to solve this expression. This expression ko solve karna kitna asaan tha, right? It hardly took me 1 or 2 minutes to solve this entire expression. If I solve the same expression using the laws of Boolean algebra, then it might take me a lot of time, plus there's a chances of mistake. Here the chances of mistakes are very less. Let me take the next example here. So in this case, again, this is a 4-variable function. So again, I have to make a k-map with 4 variables. Okay. So you can also note down the amount of time that it will take me to solve. I'm trying to explain at the same time, also trying to solve. So it will not take me hardly 1 or 2 minutes to solve this one. So I can say it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. And the locations are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14 and 15. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पर ये जो locations है, this is representing a value 0, 0, 1, 0, which is 2. This is 1, 1, 1, 0, which is 14. This is 1, 0, 1, 0, that is 10. This is 1, 0, 1, 1, that is 11. This is 1, 0, 0, 8. This is 1, 1, 0, 0, 12. This is 00113. This is all zeros. Okay, so that means we have a value 1 at the location 2. We have a value 1 at the location 14. We have a value 1 at the location 10. We have a value 1 at the location 11. We have a value 1 at the location 8. Then we have a value 1 at the location 12. Then we have a value 1 at the location 3. And then we have a value 1 in this location, right? So these are the ones that we have. Now I want to make the subcube as big as possible. Jitne bade subcube hum yahan par bana sakte hain, I want to make the subcubes as big as possible. Okay, let me show you kya kya subcube ban sakte hain. So what I can do here is, I can combine these 4 ones. Main in 4 ones ko ek saath combine kar sakta hun. So this is a subcube of size. This is a subcube of size, you know, how much size it is? This is a subcube of size 4. At the same time, I can combine all the ones in the corner. So all these ones in the corner, I can again make one more subcube of size 4. So ye mere paas ek aur subcube banega jiska size 4 hai. And at the same time, I can also make one more subcube, which is of size 4. So I can combine these two ones with these two ones. So I can have, so you can clearly see here, I can make total of 3 subcubes, and the size of each of these subcube is 4. Har ek subcube ka size 4 hai. So because size of each of these subcube is 4, so this expression can be minimized to only 6 literals. For with every min term, I'm going to have only 2 variables. Let me write all of them one by one. ठीक है, let me take the first green one. सबसे पहले मैं green को लेता हूँ. Let me try to explain what this green is representing. So in this green one, we have A is same as well as D is same. So this is representing A and D complementation. ये A D complement को represent कर रहा है. Okay? And let us suppose I'm taking this one. So in this one, we have B complement is same. B complement आपके पास same है. At the same time, D complement is same. So this is representing B complement and D complement. ये B complement और D complement को represent कर रहा है. If I take this yellow one, अगर मैं इस yellow वाले को लूँगा, so in this yellow one, we have B complement here, B complement, and at the same time C is there. So it is B complement C. Therefore, the solution equation that I can have here, the solution equation is A D complement plus B complement plus D complement B complement C. This is representing B complement C. So sorry. This is B complement C. So this will be the solution equation for this given function. So you can see how easy it was to solve this question. So these are such a difficult questions, they are such a big questions, and it becomes very easy to solve such questions regarding with the help of K-map. If you try to solve the same question without using the K-map, it will take a lot of time. Aapka kaafi time jo hai is question mein waste hoga. So using the K-map, things become very easy, things become very simple. Now let us take this next example. So as you can see, this is a very big question here. So here we are having a K-map. I think I just have to skip the yes. So here we have a K-map, which is a 4 variable K-map. I think I've solved it. Let me check again. This is done. This is done. This is also done. Yeah. So here again, we are having a 4 variable K-map. So in this 4 variable K-map, this is your K-map. This is representing AB. This is representing CD. Here we have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. This is basically 1, 1. This is 1, 0. Again, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. And the values in these locations are, let me write them out. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay. And now let us analyze what are the locations where this function is assuming a value of 1. So this is 0, 0. This is 0, 0, 0, 1, which is equal to 1 only. This is 0, 1, 0, 1, which is 5. This is 0, 1, 1, 7. This is 6. This is 12. This is 13. This is representing 15, and this is representing 11. Okay. So 1 here we have a 1, then 5 here we have a 1, 7 here we have a 1, then we have 6 here we have a 1, at 12 we have a 1, 13 we have a 1, and 15 we have a 1. So these are the ones that we have. Okay. Let us try to make the subcube. I can make this subcube. It is a very, very big subcube. Correct. And at the same time, I can also make this subcube, I can make this subcube, I can make this subcube, and here you can see we also have 11. So 11 is also there. That means I can also make this subcube. So this is the K-map, and these are the subcubes that are possible. Now in these subcubes, you will identify that all of these orange subcubes, they are essential prime implicants. Ye jo hai, ye essential prime implicant hai. Here it is also representing an essential prime implicant. Here it is also representing an essential prime implicant. Here it is also presenting an essential prime implicant, but this blue subQ, ये जो blue आपके पास आया है, this is just a prime implicant, it is not essential prime. So basically in our solution, every essential prime implicant should be there, but for the prime implicant, we have to make a choice whether we want to take it or not. But here you can see this prime implicant, all the terms that are present in this prime implicant, all of these terms are covered by essential prime. So basically ये जिस one को cover कर रहा है उसको बाकी सभी cover कर रहा है, बाकी सभी essential prime को ये cover कर रहा है. इसके अंदर कोई ऐसी extra term नहीं है जो कि दूसरे essential prime cover नहीं कर रहे, right? So that means in our solution I do not need this subcube. इसकी मुझे कोई भी ज़रूरत नहीं, even though I can add it, but still further minimization is possible. I do not need this subcube. So I take the concept of essential prime, then you will understand that why I do not need it. So for as of now, let us try to give a solution, okay? So this one, this subcube is representing A, B and C complement. And this subcube is representing C, D and A. This subcube here, this one is representing your A complement, B and this is C, right? So here A complement, B and C. And this subcube is representing your A complement, C complement and D, right? So that means in our solution, your solution equation will be A, B, C complement plus A, C, D plus A complement, B, C plus A complement, C complement, D. So this is the solution equation. These are the minimum number of literals in this solution equation. So this solution equation mein ye sabhi minimum number of literals hain. Okay, so I hope that you understood the solution. Aap sabhi ko solution samajh mein aaya hoga. Any doubts? Agar koi bhi doubt hai, please feel free to ask your doubts. Now, in this case, this expression, how many number of literals are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 into 4, or you can say 32 literals are present in this entire expression. Us puri expression mein 32 literals hain, but this minimized expression is only having 12 literals. जो हमारी minimized expression है उसके अंदर सिर्फ 12 literals हैं और इस पूरी expression में हमारे पास 32 literals थे, okay? So you can clearly see how much we have minimized that given expression, okay? So again here, this time I'll take a function. Instead of taking an expression, I'll take a function and I'll try to represent this function using the K-map and I'll try to minimize this function. So here this is a 3-variable function. ये आपका जो function है, ये 3-variable function है. So because it is a 3-variable function, that is why I need a K-map which is having 8 cells, okay? These are all the 8 cells. Here we have A, here we have B and C. This location is 0, this location is 1. So here 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. These locations are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. ये सभी आपके पास locations हैं. So this is the decimal number 0. This is the decimal number 3. This is the decimal number 4. This is not there, right? So it is not there. And this is the decimal number which is 7, right? So that means at the location 0, 3, 4 and 7. In these locations, we are having 1s. In sabhi locations par aapke paas 1 hai. Now I can make a subcube here. Kya kya subcube bana sakte hain? I can make this as a subcube. I can make this as a subcube. We cannot combine them. Hum inko combine nahi kar sakte because between this and this variable, or you can say between this and this location, there is a change of 2 bits. Because there is a change of 2 bits, we cannot combine them. So I can have only two subcubes here. And both of these two subcubes are essential prime implicants. So this is representing B complement, C complement, and this is representing BC. Therefore, the solution to this given equation is B complement, C complement plus BC, or you can say B XNOR C. Solution kya hoga aapke paas? B XNOR C. So in this manner, you can solve this equation. As you can see, solving it is so easy and so simple. Kitna asaan hai is equation ko solve karna. Okay? So now again, this is the question for you. Aap sabhi ko ye question lena hai. Please try to solve it. I've taken this question for you. Aap sabhi ko ye question solve karna hai. Okay? Now in the next video, in this next session, let us try to identify what are prime implicants, what are essential prime implicants. Okay? And let us try to solve more questions based on that. We will meet in the next video.